Here we have a series circuit with three resistors. We want to use the multimeter to measure the voltage drop across each resistor. But before we do that, let's try some calculations. Voltage drop can be calculated by taking the total voltage in the current and multiplying it by the ratio of the resistor over the total resistance in the circuit. So how do we figure this out? In this particular circuit, we have three resistors. The battery is 6 volts. Each resistor is 150 ohms. This adds up to a total of 450 ohms. The ratio is 150 over 450, which is exactly 1/3. 1/3 of 6 volts is going to be 2 volts. Now let's use the multimeter to see if our calculations were correct. Put the knob of your multimeter to 20 volts. We could use 2 volts, but since that's our estimate, we want to go one step higher. Use your two probes and place them on either end of the resistor. Sometimes just touching them doesn't give you enough of a good value, so then use the alligator clips to clip each leg. You may have to wait a little bit for the multimeter to settle down on a value. It's settling right at 1.95. That's really close to the 2 volts that we estimated. Also note, you only want to measure a voltage drop this way. If you're trying to measure resistance with your multimeter, then please take the resistor out of the circuit. Never measure resistance in a live circuit. Notice that the voltage drop on the other resistors is also right around 2 volts. That's because each resistor is exactly identical to the other, and so the ratio is 1/3 for each of them. Here we have a new series circuit. This time each resistor is 220 ohms. We can apply the same formula as before, and what we will find is that the ratio is the same as previously. What this tells us is that it's not the exact number of the resistor that matters, but this ratio of the resistance over the total resistance. We calculated a voltage drop of 2 volts across this 220 ohm resistor, and the multimeter confirms that that is the voltage drop. For this next circuit, we've changed up our resistors. Our first resistor is 1000 or 1k ohms. Our second resistor is also 1k ohms, but our last resistor is 10,000 or 10k ohms. Now our total resistance is 12K. Let's find our ratio. This should be 1 over 12. This should be 10 over 12. This should also be 1 over 12. And we multiply it by our original 6 volts. So the first resistor should be exactly 1/2 volt. And the last one should be a 5-volt drop. The multimeter confirms our calculations that the 10K resistor has a 5-volt drop, while the 1K resistor only has a 1/2 volt drop. So why do we care so much about voltage drop? Well, many Arduino sensors work by using something called a voltage divider. What happens is that the sensor is actually a variable resistor. That means that the resistance changes depending on some other factor. In the case of our photosensor, the amount of light will either increase or decrease the amount of resistance in this resistor. Our second resistor in the circuit is going to be a 1K ohm. As the photosensor values change, the voltage drop across this particular resistor is also going to change. We can read this value by adding a wire that goes to the Arduino analog. Let's test out our photode sensor using the multimeter. Notice that right now, the voltage drop across the photosensor is 4 volts. That means that it's going to get a lot more voltage here than on our 1K resistor. In fact, about twice as much. This implies that the current resistance is about twice the value of the 1K resistor, or 2,000 ohms. What happens when we shine a light on it? Notice that the voltage drop is drastically decreasing. In fact, now the photosensor probably has a resistor value about half of that of the 1K resistor, so only around 500 ohms. What happens if we change the light to even darker? If you cover up the resistor, notice that the voltage drop increased even more. The same information about voltage drop can be read by your Arduino board using the analog input signal. Simply place the wire between your sensor and your other resistor. As the voltage drop changes, you will get different values in your serial monitor of your Arduino. The values can range anywhere from 0 to 1023. This represents the bottom level and highest level of the voltage drop that you could possibly get.